This is the SAP Developer News for August the 14th, 2025.
Hola, amigos.
Hola.
Hola.
We're here in Mexico City. Rich Heilman, Thomas Young, Antonio. I'm not going to say his last name. But I'm just going to murder it anyway. We're in Mexico City doing a code jam today. We were in Lima on Monday.
Yes.
Very good code jams.
Monday and Tuesday.
Monday and Tuesday. We did a meetup on Monday night. It was very good. We had a nice German restaurant, beers and food. It was very nice. And today we're in Mexico City again. We just finished the code jam. And then tonight we're going to have another meetup. And I think we're going to have a record number at the meetup tonight, which is going to be great. And then next week, Antonio and I will be off to Bogota, Colombia to do another two code jams and another meetup. So
what topics have we been doing?
We're doing,
why am I talking the whole time?
I don't know. And we're doing, the topics are on AI core and RAP. And we're taking a little bit of a slant on this trip. We're doing Joule for ABAP developers. So putting the hands to keyboard using Joule and all the good things that come with that.
Yep. It's like the only place that people can get access to it to try it out right now.
That's right.
Come to a code jam and use it for real.
Yep. And we had a good day today. A lot of interactions. So many people just working together on the exercises, chatting together. It was really great. I loved it. It's great.
Cool. Yeah. So be on the lookout for code jams coming to a city near you in the future, hopefully, and join us for one of these.
Yep. Bye for now.
Ciao.
Howdy, y'all. Have y'all ever been working on the front end on a table with a filter bar, maybe, and needed to change the label on one of the values that's shown in both places, but only happened to remember to do it in one place? I mean, I definitely haven't done that before, but I know that someone out there must have. So for those of us, those of y'all who have, SAP has introduced new capability in SAP UI5 Flexibility that may help solve this kind of problem. The blog post link below highlights how non-developers and developers can easily customize and manage these kinds of text updates by focusing more on the data model itself. This will allow users to make consistent tech changes in apps more efficiently. This feature will also help make it easier to prevent those silly little mistakes we've all made in the past. Check out the blog post for more info on the other ways that SAP UI5 Flexibility can help improve your own workflow. I hope y'all are having a wonderful bug-free day, and as always, happy coding!
Hey everyone. As you know, cap25 was in July last month. And if you missed it, if you couldn't join, or if you missed some sessions or the keynote, I have good news for you. You can go over to the cap25 website, and there you will find all the recordings for the sessions and the keynote as of now. So head over to cap25 documentation website to get all the sessions and keynote from cap25.
Hola, SAP developers. I'm here at the SAP office in Bogota, Colombia, where we just did the last code jam as part of the LATAM Roadshow. An attendee today highlighted how much the learning offerings from SAP have changed in the past few years, how the learning content is easily accessible, the quality of the content, and how he has learned a lot thanks to SAP Learning. I want to share with you three new learning offerings related to SAP Integration Suite that were recently published in learning.sap.com. First, the administering SAP Integration Suite learning journey. This learning journey offers everything you need to know regarding administering SAP Integration Suite, including essential tasks, setup, capability management, and role responsibilities. Also, for those of you migrating from PIPO to SAP Integration Suite, there are two new learning journeys, so you can get familiar with Edge Integration Cell, the hybrid integration runtime part of SAP Integration Suite. Edge Integration Cell allows you to manage APIs and run integration scenarios within your private landscape. One learning journey focuses on running Edge Integration Cell on SUSE Rancher Kubernetes Engine, and the other one on Red Hat OpenShift. Both of these learning journeys start on the 19th of August And if you complete them by the 30th of September, you can earn a record of achievement. Happy learning!